All right, so are you ready to dive into some seriously lazy ways to make money online? We're talking like minimum effort, maximum relaxation while the cash rolls in. At least that's the dream.
Oh, absolutely. And everyone's looking for that magic formula, especially in 2024. Luckily, there are some interesting methods emerging.
That's what we're here to explore. We've got a whole bunch of sources from those 20 lazy ways to make money, YouTube videos to actual advice from people making bank on freelance
A good
platforms.
mix of like the hype and the reality, which is what we're all about.
For sure. So, first up, we've got AI-powered proofreading. Imagine this. You sprawled out on the couch, maybe some snacks, and your AI buddy is slaving away, catching every single grammar error.
And it's not just about catching errors anymore. We're talking AI like ChatGPT actually suggesting better phrasing, improving the text overall. So you're spending less time fixing things and more time improving.
Right, so you can power through more work and theoretically make more money. One source even said you could earn, what was it, like $15 to $100 an hour doing this?
Yeah, the earning potential is there, especially
Wow.
on platforms like guru.com, which is packed with proofreading gigs. In fact, one source mentioned a guru.com user who had made over $400,000 just from proofreading.
Whoa, hold on. $400,000.
Okay.
Okay, maybe lazy isn't the right word.
Well, you still have to like hustle and build a client base, but the point is, you don't necessarily need to be a grammar expert to make this work. The AI does the heavy lifting.
True enough. Okay, this next one might be right up your alley if you're a podcast fan. AI-assisted transcription.
Yep. Basically getting paid to listen, which sounds pretty good already. But the real game changer is the AI tools like Rev and Otter.ai that do most of the transcribing for you.
Right. And with accuracy getting better all the time, it's less about typing everything out and more about just cleaning up the AI's work. One source said they make like $0 to $1 per minute of audio.
So if you think about it, with AI doing the bulk of the work, you could easily hit $30, $60 per hour just fine-tuning those transcripts.
Okay, see, now that's what I'm talking about. Low effort, decent money. Speaking of which, you're not going to believe this, but one of our sources talked about this faceless YouTube channel, right? Apparently, they're making $4,000 a month from a single video that they posted like a year ago.
That's the power of evergreen content on YouTube. And with automation, you can kind of set it and forget it.
Faceless YouTube automation. I gotta admit, that sounds kind of cool and kind of creepy at the same time. Break it down for me. What's the deal with this?
So basically, you're using AI to do all the stuff that usually requires a person, like, writing the script, recording the
Yeah.
voiceover, even editing the video. So you don't ever have to actually show your face.
Wait, so you're telling me I can be a YouTuber without ever worrying about like lighting or what my hair looks like? Sign me up. But seriously, how does that even work?
Well, there's AI for that. You've got tools like Script AI that generate scripts based on whatever topic you want. Then you can use 11 Labs to create a voiceover, and they sound incredibly real. And for editing, there's InVideo. It's all powered by AI.
Wow, it's like having a whole production team, but without the actual people and the hassle. That's wild.
It is pretty amazing. And if you focus on high CPM niches like, say, finance, tech, business, you can maximize your earning potential.
High CPM, meaning you make more money per view, right? So basically, create evergreen content in a profitable niche and you're golden.
Exactly. Once you upload that video, it can generate revenue for months, even years, without you having to lift a finger.
All right, I'm adding become a faceless YouTuber to my to-do list. Now, this next one, it might take a bit more work up front, but hear me out. Social media account flipping. Imagine building up a dedicated following in a specific niche and then cashing out by selling that account.
It's becoming more and more popular, especially with platforms like FameSwap, making it easy to connect with buyers.
And people are making serious bank doing this. One source showed examples from FameSwap. Like, there was a TikTok account with 100,000 followers that sold for $900. Another one, an Instagram account, had 55,000 followers and went for $500.
It's not just about the follower count, though. You need engagement, a clear niche, the potential to make money from the account. It all factors in.
So it's about quality over quantity. But how do you even build an account that's attractive enough to sell in the first place?
First things first, find your niche. What are you actually interested in? What kind of communities are out there that you could tap into? Once you've got that, you can start creating content that really resonates with that specific audience.
So all those hours I spend scrolling through Instagram might actually be considered market research. Who knew?
Hey, if it gives you a better understanding of what works, why not? And then to speed things up, you can use platforms like like4like.org or even bots to automate some of the engagement.
Likeforlike.org. So it's like a you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours kind of deal to boost your numbers.
Exactly. It can be helpful in the beginning, but, and this is important, don't rely on it too much. You want genuine engagement, not just bots.
That makes sense. So you build up your following, create great content, and then what? How do you actually sell the account?
Platforms like FameSwap, they act as the middleman, making sure everything is above board and secure.
So it's like selling a domain name, but instead of a website, it's a whole community you've built.
Exactly. You're selling the potential for income and influence.
This is seriously interesting stuff. So we've got proofreading, transcription, faceless YouTube, flipping social media accounts. What other lazy money-making gems do we have up our sleeve?
Have you ever thought about being a tech wizard? Because this next method might just convince you that you are, and the best part is you don't need to know a single line of code.
Wait, are you serious? Are you telling me I can build websites now?
That's the beauty of AI, my friend. You don't need to be a coding genius anymore. These AI tools can practically build a website for you while you sip your coffee.
Okay, now you've got my attention. Tell me more.
Picture this. You, sitting back, giving commands to an army of AI bots who are building a website exactly the way you want. That's what a tool like 10web lets you do.
10web. I've heard of those drag-and-drop website builders, but this sounds next level.
Oh, it's definitely next level. You know how you copy and paste text? Well, 10web can practically copy and paste entire websites. You just give it a URL, and it analyzes the design, the structure, even the content, and it can create a replica.
Whoa, hold on. So I can clone any website on the internet. That's kind of scary, but also super cool.
It is powerful, right? But
yeah.
Like with anything powerful, you got to use it responsibly.
Okay, so let's say I'm using my newfound AI website building powers for good. How does this translate into actual money?
Businesses are always willing to pay good money for a professional-looking website. And with AI handling all the technical stuff, you could potentially pump out multiple websites a month, which means more money in your pocket.
Makes sense. But how much are we talking here? What's a realistic price range?
Well, according to our research, freelancers on Fiverr are charging anywhere from $800 to $2,000 per website. And the best part is, with AI, you can actually deliver on that kind of price without burning yourself out.
$800 to $2,000 per website, multiple websites a month.
Okay, I'm starting to see the appeal of this whole lazy money thing.
It's about working smarter, not harder. And with AI constantly evolving, who knows what other money-making opportunities are just around the corner.
All right, I'm sold. So far, I'm convinced I can proofread, transcribe, become a faceless YouTuber, flip social media accounts, and build websites, all with the help of AI. What else can we add to this lazy entrepreneur starter pack?
Well, with podcasts becoming more popular than ever, there's a huge demand for, you guessed it, podcast editing. And let me tell you, people are willing to pay a premium for it. That's right. We talked about transcription, but editing is a whole different ballgame. It's time-consuming and it can get expensive. One of the sources we looked at, they charge like $60 to $140 per episode for editing.
And I totally get it. Editing can be a pain, but luckily there's AI for that too.
Oh, you know, I love hearing that. AI to the rescue once again. So what kind of magic can AI work on my podcast?
Think about all the annoying things like background noise, uneven audio, all those ums and ahs that we all do. Tools like cleanvoice.ai can clean that up in a snap.
Wait, it does all of that automatically? I need to get my hands on this cleanvoice thing. I bet podcasters would be all over this.
They absolutely are. The beauty is, by using AI, you can turn around episodes much faster and take on more clients, which means more money.
See, this is what I'm talking about. AI. Making us all look good and boosting our bank accounts. And this last method is all about working smarter, not harder. We're talking YouTube shorts, but with an affiliate marketing twist.
Ah, yes, the dynamic duo. And it can be incredibly lucrative. One source claimed to make $23,000 in just 30 days using this strategy.
$23,000 in 30 days? Okay, I'm all ears. Spill the secrets. How does it work?
Remember all those viral YouTube videos and podcasts we were talking about earlier? Instead of starting from scratch, you repurpose that content into engaging shorts.
So basically, take the best parts of something that's already popular and repackage it for a new audience.
Exactly. And the best part is, you don't even have to do the editing yourself. Tools like clickingshort.com can take a long video and chop it up into shorts automatically.
Okay, so I've got my attention-grabbing shorts. Where does the affiliate marketing part come in?
Right in the description. You find high-ticket products that are relevant to the content and drop your affiliate links there. So, for example, let's say your shorts are about fitness. You could include affiliate links to workout programs, equipment, stuff like that.
Genius. Find something people already love, make it short and sweet, and boom, passive income.
Pretty much. Although, you know, consistency is key.
Of course, there's always some level of effort involved, but these methods definitely make the whole making money online thing a lot less daunting and maybe even a bit more fun.
Exactly. It's about finding ways to earn while enjoying the process.
Couldn't agree more. So before we get too carried away dreaming about all the lazy money we're going to make, what are some key takeaways we should keep in mind?
I think the most important thing is that even though these methods are labeled as lazy, they still require some level of effort, consistency, and you always have to be willing to adapt because the online world is constantly changing.
That's a really good point. There's no magic button, but it's pretty inspiring to know that there are accessible, even enjoyable ways to make money online.
Exactly. And with so many options, it's really about finding what speaks to you and what fits into your life.
I love that. So for everyone listening, think about this. If you could add one of these income streams to your life effortlessly, which one would you pick? Would it be the laid-back vibe of AI-powered proofreading? Or maybe the podcast enthusiast's dream of AI-assisted transcription?
Or perhaps the creative freedom of faceless YouTube automation? Or the entrepreneurial spirit of social media account flipping? There are so many possibilities.
Too many possibilities. It's almost overwhelming.
But in a good way. The key is to explore, experiment, find what feels right for you. You might even be inspired to combine a few of these and create something totally unique.
Now you're talking. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. We still have a whole bunch of other lazy money-making methods to unpack. Next up, we're exploring a method that turns your daily commute into a source of passive income. Get ready for car advertising.
Yeah, turning your car into a moving billboard. Not a bad way to make some extra cash.
Right. And we're not talking about those tiny bumper stickers either. We're talking full-on wraps that turn your car into, like, a work of art. Well, an advertisement, but still. One source mentioned companies paying, get this, $400 to $800 a month for a car wrap.
It's true. And there are companies like Carvertise that specialize in this. They connect drivers with brands looking for more creative ways to advertise. It's a win-win.
Yeah, advertisers get their message out there and drivers get paid just for driving around like they normally would. Sign me up. Are there any catches?
Well, there are usually some requirements. Like, your car might have to be a certain model or year, or you might need to drive a certain number of miles each month.
Makes sense. They want to make sure the ads are actually being seen by people. But still, if you qualify, it seems like a pretty passive way to earn some extra bucks.
Absolutely. And it shows how the line between online and offline income is blurring. There are so many cool opportunities popping up that blend the two.
Totally. Speaking of online, let's talk about how to actually navigate this whole making money online thing. The internet's huge. It's constantly changing. Where do we even begin?
It can be overwhelming, for sure. But the good news is there's no shortage of information out there. Blogs, podcasts, online courses, you name it. The key is finding reliable sources.
That's so true. It's easy to get caught up in those get-rich-quick schemes, but those rarely pan out. So how do we separate the legit opportunities from the scams?
Look for people who have a proven track record, people who are actually making money the right way, and be wary of anything that sounds too good to be true.
Solid advice. Speaking of legit opportunities, let's talk about something that's been gaining a lot of traction, user-generated content, or UGC for short.
UGC. It's all about brands realizing that sometimes the best content comes from real people, not fancy ad agencies.
And the best part is you don't need millions of followers to get in on the action. One source said that brands are actively looking for people with smaller but highly engaged followings to create authentic content.
Exactly. It's about quality over quantity. A genuine post from someone with a few thousand followers can be way more effective than a generic ad campaign from a big company.
So instead of just scrolling through Instagram, we can actually get paid for sharing our unique perspectives and experiences. That's awesome.
Exactly. And there's a huge range of UGC that brands are looking for: photos, videos, reviews, testimonials.
So if you're good at photography, video editing, even just writing, there's probably an opportunity out there for you.
Exactly. And platforms are popping up all over the place that connect creators with brands, which makes finding these opportunities even easier.
That's so cool. It's like the gig economy is evolving right before our eyes.
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about another platform where you can monetize your creativity. Etsy.
It's not just for handmade crafts anymore.
Yep. Digital products are where it's at. Think printable planners, templates, ebooks, online courses. The possibilities are endless.
And the best part about digital products is that you create them once and you can sell them over and over again. No need to worry about inventory or shipping. It's passive income gold.
Exactly. So let's say I'm inspired to create my own digital empire. What are the key steps to selling on Etsy?
First, you got to find your niche. What are you passionate about? What's already selling well on Etsy? Once you've got an idea, it's time to create your product.
So if you're a design guru, you could whip up some amazing social media templates. If you're an organization pro, maybe you create the ultimate printable planner.
Exactly. Then you just list it on Etsy. Make sure your product description is top-notch, you've got a competitive price, and you're using the right keywords so people can find you.
Got it. So I've got my product listed. Now it's all about sitting back and watching the sales roll in, right?
You wish. Etsy does have a built-in audience, but you still need to promote your shop. Use your social media, maybe run some ads.
So it's not entirely passive, but hey, compared to running a brick-and-mortar store, selling digital products on Etsy sounds like a dream.
For sure. It's perfect for people who want flexibility and the freedom to work from anywhere.
And speaking of flexibility and working from anywhere, let's talk about online tutoring and teaching.
The virtual classroom is booming right now. With more and more people embracing online learning, it's a great time to share your knowledge with the world.
And it's not just about traditional subjects either. People are paying for all sorts of skills online. Language lessons, music instruction, coding workshops, business coaching, you name it.
Exactly. Whatever you're passionate about, whatever you're good at, chances are there's someone out there who wants to learn from you.
So if you've ever thought about teaching but weren't sure about the whole classroom setting, online tutoring could be a great option.
Absolutely. Plus, there are tons of platforms that connect tutors and students globally, which makes getting started super easy.
So whether you're a math whiz, a grammar guru, or a coding ninja, you can earn some extra cash by empowering others.
Love that. It's like a win-win. You share your knowledge, they gain new skills, everyone's happy. And it shows how technology can make education more accessible to everyone.
It's amazing when you think about it. Okay, we've got to talk about the holy grail of passive income, affiliate marketing. We touched on it earlier with YouTube Shorts, but let's dive a little deeper.
Right, affiliate marketing. It's basically getting paid to promote other people's products.
Exactly. You find a company or a product you love, you tell people about it, and if they buy it through your unique link, you get a commission.
And the best part is, you don't have to create your own product, deal with customer service, any of that. Your job is to drive traffic and make those sales.
And those commissions can add up quickly. We're talking anywhere from a few percent to 50% or more, depending on the program.
Yeah, the earning potential is definitely there. But it takes work. You need a solid strategy, and you need to put in the effort to make it work.
Okay, so we get the theory. But how do you actually put it into practice? How do you find good affiliate programs?
There are tons of affiliate networks and platforms out there. ClickBank, ShareASale, Amazon Associates, just to name a few.
So if I'm really into sustainable living, I could find an affiliate network that focuses on eco-friendly products, find brands I love, and promote them to my audience.
Exactly. Once you sign up for a program, they'll give you a unique affiliate link to share.
And how do I promote that link effectively? Can I just spam it all over my social media and call it a day?
Not quite. Well, you could try, but it's not exactly a recipe for success. People can smell a sales pitch a mile away. The key is to provide value.
Right, so don't just push products. Create content that's actually helpful, entertaining, informative.
Exactly. That's how you build trust with your audience, and that's how you ultimately make sales.
So going back to the sustainable living example, I could write a blog post with eco-friendly tips, make a video reviewing my favorite products, share my sustainable swaps on Instagram.
Exactly. You're naturally integrating your affiliate links into content that people actually want to see.
It's a win-win. People get valuable information, and I get a little something-something for my efforts. But like anything worth doing, it takes effort and consistency, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Affiliate marketing isn't a get-rich-quick scheme. But if you're willing to put in the work, it can be an amazing way to create a passive income stream.
Love that. Okay, let's talk about a method that puts a little extra cash back in your pocket. Cashback apps and browser extensions.
Oh yeah, cashback apps are so popular right now, and for good reason. Who doesn't love getting money back on their purchases?
It's like getting paid to shop, which, let's be real, is everyone's dream. We're talking apps like Rakuten and Honeyray.
Those are some of the big ones, and they partner with tons of different retailers. You're bound to find some of your favorite stores on there.
Okay, but how does it actually work? Do I need to jump through hoops to get my cash back?
Not at all. It's super simple. First, you create an account with the Cashback platform. Once you're logged in, you can either browse their list of retailers or search for a specific store.
So let's say I desperately need new shoes. I'd search shoes on the app and see which stores are offering cash back.
Exactly. Then you click their link through the Cashback app. It'll redirect you to the store's website, and you just shop like you normally would.
So instead of going directly to the store's website, I access it through the app. Got it.
Easy peasy. You add stuff to your cart, you check out, and the cashback magically appears in your account.
Magically? Does it really happen that fast?
Okay, maybe not magically. It usually takes a few days for the cashback to be processed.
Yep.
But still, pretty effortless if you ask me.
And once the cashback is in my account, what can I do with it?
Most platforms give you a few options. You can usually transfer it to your bank account, redeem it for gift cards, or even donate it to charity.
Wait, seriously? So not only am I earning money back, but I can also support a good cause. I'm sold.
It's a great way to make your shopping habits work for you while also giving back.
Cashback apps, making the world a better and slightly richer place.
Yeah.
Okay, this next one's for all the gamers out there. Have you ever dreamed of getting paid to play video games?
I think that's everyone's dream, right? But seriously, playtesting is a real thing. And it's becoming more accessible all the time.
And it's not just about playing for fun, right? You're
right.
Actually providing valuable feedback that helps shape the development of the game.
Exactly. Developers rely on playtesters to find bugs, identify areas for improvement, and make sure the game is as enjoyable as possible.
So you need to be like a professional gamer to be a playtester.
Not at all. While some opportunities might require specific skills, there are tons of entry-level playtesting gigs out there that are open to anyone who loves games.
So let's say I'm sold on this whole playtesting thing. Where do I even start?
There are a bunch of websites that connect playtesters with game developers. One popular option is Playtest Cloud.
Oh yeah, I've heard of Playtest Cloud. They do remote testing, right? So you can literally get paid to play games from your couch.
Exactly. You create a profile, tell them what kind of games you're into, and they'll match you with relevant playtests.
So they send you a game, and you just tell them what you think.
Pretty much. They might ask you to complete specific tasks, like testing a new level or trying to find glitches, or they might just ask for your general feedback on the gameplay, the story, the graphics.
It's like being a part of the creative process. You're actually influencing how the game is made. That's so cool.
It's a dream job for a lot of people. And it's becoming more and more accessible every day.
Speaking of accessible, let's circle back to building and flipping social media accounts. It's one of those things that sounds a little intimidating at first, but it can be incredibly lucrative.
It's true. And it's only getting more popular. People are making serious money buying and selling social media accounts.
We talked about it earlier, but can you remind me, what makes an account valuable enough to sell?
It all comes down to having a dedicated, engaged following in a specific niche. The more focused your audience, the better.
So instead of trying to appeal to everyone, you should really hone in on a specific topic or interest.
Exactly. That way you can establish yourself as an authority in that niche, and that's what attracts buyers.
So if I'm really passionate about, say, sustainable fashion, I could create an account dedicated to showcasing eco-friendly brands, thrifting tips, that kind of thing.
Perfect example.
Yeah.
And by consistently creating great content, using relevant hashtags, and engaging with your followers, you can grow that account organically.
What about people who don't have the patience for organic growth? Are there any shortcuts?
There are always shortcuts, but they're not always the best approach. Some people use shoutouts, paid ads, even automated bots to boost their followers. But those methods can be risky, and they don't always result in genuine engagement.
Good to know. So let's say I've managed to build a thriving account, got a loyal following, good engagement, the whole nine yards. How do I actually go about selling it?
Well, that's where platforms like FameSwap come in. It's basically a marketplace for buying and selling social media accounts.
Right. FameSwap. It's like eBay, but for social media.
Exactly. You list your account, highlight all the key stats, and potential buyers can check it out and make offers.
So similar to selling a domain name, you're selling a digital asset with the potential to generate income or influence.
Precisely. And the price can vary widely, depending on the niche, the engagement rate, the monetization potential.
Makes sense. It's definitely not as simple as just slapping a price tag on your account and calling it a day. But hey, for the right person, building and flipping social media accounts could be a lucrative side hustle.
Absolutely. If you've got an entrepreneurial spirit and you're willing to put in the work, sky's the limit.
Love it. Okay, Let's talk about some truly passive income streams, the kind where you set it and forget it and watch the money roll in.
Now you're speaking my language. What do you have in mind?
Passive income apps, baby.
Passive income apps. I'm intrigued. Tell me more.
We're talking about getting paid for doing everyday things on your phone, browsing the web, using certain apps, even just receiving TAF messages.
Okay, now that sounds intriguing. How does that even work?
Well, these apps generate revenue through partnerships with different companies. Basically, they get paid to show you ads or collect data, and they share a portion of that revenue with you.
Interesting. So, for example, a cashback app might partner with a retailer and offer its users exclusive deals, then reward them with cash back for their purchases.
Exactly. And there are tons of different passive income apps out there, each with its own unique way of earning. One of our sources mentioned a few interesting ones, like SMS cashback, which pays you for receiving texts. There's Red Pocket Mobile, which rewards you for sharing web data. And Honeygain, which lets you earn passive income by sharing your internet connection.
Okay, those sound pretty cool. But are they legit? Do people actually make money from these apps?
That's a valid question. Like, with anything online, you gotta do your research. Look for apps from reputable companies, read reviews, make sure they have transparent earning structures and clear privacy policies.
Solid advice. It's always better to be safe than sorry.
Exactly. Now, I'm not saying you're gonna get rich quick using passive income apps, but they can be a nice little way to earn some extra cash without really lifting a finger.
It's like getting paid to live your life.
Exactly. And with more and more passive income apps popping up all the time, there's bound to be something out there for everyone.
I love it. So many options to explore.
This has been quite the deep dive. We've covered a ton of different ways to make money online, from side hustles to passive income streams and everything in between.
It's amazing how many opportunities there are for anyone who's willing to put in a little effort.
Absolutely. And as we wrap up this part of our discussion, I want to leave you with a little thought experiment. Imagine combining any two of the methods we've discussed to create your own unique online income stream. What would your ultimate lazy money-making hybrid be?
Ooh, so many possibilities. See, this is why I love exploring this stuff. There are so many creative ways to make money online these days.
Right. Like, what if you combine the faceless YouTube automation thing with affiliate marketing? You could be raking in passive income from those shorts without ever having to show your face on camera.
Genius.
Yeah.
Or you could use your newfound AI website building powers to create a platform for selling digital products on Etsy.
Okay, now you're talking. A whole online empire built on AI and laziness. I love it.
The possibilities are truly endless. And that's what's so exciting. It's all about finding what works for you, what you're passionate about, and then getting creative with it.
Couldn't agree more. And the best part is the online world is constantly evolving. So who knows what new opportunities are just around the corner.
Exactly. The key is to stay curious, keep learning, and never be afraid to experiment.
Beautifully said. So to everyone listening, that's our deep dive into the world of lazy money making. We've explored a ton of different methods, and hopefully we've sparked some ideas for you.
And remember, the journey to financial freedom is a marathon, not a sprint.
So true. Don't get discouraged if you don't become an online millionaire overnight. Just take it one step at a time, find what you enjoy, and most importantly, have fun with it.
Absolutely. And never stop learning and growing.
Could have said it better myself. That's it for this episode, everyone. Until next time, happy hustling.